My name is Urvashi Singh and I work at Graven. I've put together 20 slides of work at Graven, mostly to illustrate the similarities in successful social spaces across hospitality, retail, offices and public spaces, like the Merchant City here. As designers, we draw on the lived experiences of people and their interactions when creating spaces for their everyday conscious or subconscious emotions that these environments generate are at the crux of everything we do. It's almost creating backdrops for people's lives. You can only do so much to create spaces for people to use and how you want them to use, but ultimately it's what people bring to these spaces themselves. We love how the sinks became the impromptu chilled bars at the Ruffians men's barbershop in Edinburgh. When designing interiors, we are often preoccupied with the tangible and intangible aspects, with its volume and physical characteristics, with how space forms the backdrop for relationships among people and objects. It's context that actually brings together different stories, which is key. There it was between the Blythesville Hotel and Harris Tweed. The chairs that were designed in the previous slide was upholstered in Harris Tweed fabrics. It was that almost saved and it helped rejuvenate one of the mills in the Outer Hebrides. We worked with Missoni Hotel, worked with Missoni Fashion House to design their five-star hotels in Kuwait. Understanding the cultural context was very important here, navigating the rituals of how people wanted to use the space. But ultimately, we kind of figured out that most people just wanted to come together. There were more similarities and differences than how people interact and use the space across the world. This was the starting point for designing this office space was people's interactions. It was drawing on the meeting at the water cooler moment, which was crudely translated into meeting at the photocopier. And that's why the series of simple spaces, which was about meeting and people interacting, took center stage in the office. It was again, this is images from the same office space where we tried to challenge the concept of a typical meeting room, creating spaces for unexpected encounters. And chance interactions. Next is some work we did for Clydesdale Bank. It was within the context of a historical building. It was creating a space not only for people who worked there, but also for more importantly for the customer and their journey, a journey that felt intuitive and comfortable. It was important here that we kind of broke the boundary between the staff and the customer and how they use the space. This retail environments, I think, rely heavily on customer journeys and experiences. And experience is a focus when we design interiors for Rocks. We think buying a piece of jewelry we felt needed some drama and a ritual with a backdrop of luxury and opulence. We created a separate space with a champagne bar and lounge and called it their thrill room. This is unlike any other retail environment in what they experience. Having a champagne bar and lounge within their stores gave them a perfect backdrop to hold gigs and events. It also gave them a platform to form collaborations and build relationships with other brands and people that they normally wouldn't have. This is a recent project we have worked on with Peacock Salt. Peacock Salt is an established importer and distributor who constantly look for new ways to surprise themselves and their customers. This is a pod within their salt factory in Ayr. The space is used for meetings and for cookery demonstrations. It was creating unexpected moments within unexpected spaces. I think is valuable and potentially quite powerful as well. Another example where context plays a very important part is some of these spaces that we designed in Accra in Ghana. The inspiration for the tiles on the walls was a celebration of local life and culture in Ghana. The fundamentals are the same everywhere in the world, where people feel a sense of ownership and belonging, forming a backdrop and, of dramas, I think, in their everyday life. This next visual is from the Radisson Red Hotel. This is a work in progress. The concept here was kind of pushing the boundaries of how operation and different social spaces come together. This is a new brand for Radisson. The intention here is for each hotel to be firmly rooted in the city that it's developed, creating a new hub for a community with mixed-use spaces. This diagram is a tool that we often use to break down the different volumes within a space and help describe a customer journey. This is a sketch we've done for Drygate. Drygate needed to be a destination venue, as it was not within the confines of bars and restaurants in the city center. Keeping this in mind, seeing the brewery and the theatrics involved in making beer was a focus of most of the bar and restaurant spaces. The next slide coming up is for the Missoni Hotel in Edinburgh. This was designed as a city center hotel within the rich cultural context of the city of Edinburgh. The Missoni brand, I think, really thrived. Part of the hotel was situated in the old building of the Royal Mile. The existing painted beams almost formed a perfect backdrop to the Missoni colors. This is the first class British Airways lounge in Glasgow. For many people, I think airport lounges are a home away from home. It's where they work, rest, and socialize. Creating a branded whiskey snug within the environment was important, not to make the people feel they're always being sold to. It was almost like it was your own personal drinks cabinet. This is the entrance lounge of the Radisson Blu Hotel in Chicago. The focus of the space and what everybody's immediately drawn to is the 6 meter long fireplace that sits in the heart of the lounge. Sometimes simple but dramatic moves within the space can immediately help to make sense of an empty space. Apologies for the poor quality of that, but this is another hotel project that we're currently working on. The challenge here is there is a 65 meter long corridor that links most of the spaces in the hotel. We developed a working title calling it The Street, almost like a busy bazaar. Sorry, thank you.